Morning, James. Has Maxine gone to school already?
Emily dropped her off.
And whereabouts is Emily?
She has a meeting.
Emily is always so busy, isn't she?
Are you hungry? What do you feel like having?
My usual.
Oh, hi, Sherman.
I like your initiative.
Thank you. So, handouts, water pitcher, TV's all set up. We're all set for the meeting.
Cool. Ah, get two coffees, black one with milk, two sugars. That's for Louis. So, two sugars, no more, no less. One green tea, two teas milk, no sugar. One green tea, medium hot.
Okay, so...
And I bought chiropractors for everyone. Take them out of the box, have them arranged nicely on a platter. And broom napkins.
Come on, I'll give you a hand. Do you remember anything? Two coffees, black, curry puffs, green tea. Everything else in between is a blank.
Don't freak out. I got just about the whole order. I used to work at a cafe in the CBD. The early morning crowd could get quite vicious.
Okay, so two coffees, black.
It's okay. You can do the curry puffs. I'll settle the rest.
Really? Mm. You're a godsend, Melody.
I was hoping the three of you can join us for dinner tomorrow. Derek would like to see Maxine.
This is going to work against you.
It's a family dinner, James.
Emily is not going to change her tune because you and Dad say so.
Don't you see? I'm compelled to do this. You and Emily don't seem to care what happens to Maxine.
Me and Emily. Our marriage hit rock bottom a long time ago, even before she decided to fool around. But if you think you can find the missing spark for us, be my guest.
I'm trying to make this right for you.
Yeah. What are my options? Either I carry on the way things are now, or me and Emily call it quits. Then you and Dad find a new Emily, we have a grand wedding, and you can start bugging me to make a new Maxine. Hmm? No thanks.
I didn't mean to push you so hard.
I have to go.
I think Eunice got the message.
I hope so. I didn't hear from her all weekend.
I made it clear to her. Go ahead and do what you want to us. Don't forget, she's the one who has the most to lose. Why?
It feels like the walls are closing in. Everyone seems to know about us. It's only a matter of time before Derek finds out.
He won't find out. I guarantee you he won't.
You don't understand. Mom hasn't told anyone about us because she doesn't want Maxine to get hurt.
Derek also shut up. That fella hates to lose face.
He's ruthless, Hawk. He will see it as a betrayal. He didn't even blink when he threw Ella out on the street.
Hey, don't get so worked up. Things are okay now, hmm? Let's enjoy it.
Ella, are you gonna tell me what happened or not? Huh? The place was in a mess. Even the gate was damaged.
I'm sorry. My friend just had to let out some steam.
Is he okay or not?
I think he will be.
Hope so.
Okay, so where will we?
I've narrowed down the list of online stores that we should target.
I had the same ones in mind. But these guys, do you think they're too mass market for us?
I was thinking it'd just be good exposure. Or I could just...
We could give them not so top priority status and move them further down the list.
Ella, can you help me with this?
Sure.
Thanks.
Sherman. I spent the whole weekend catching up.
So you're an authority on all things Helena?
I guess I'm just better equipped than before. It got me thinking, I have a couple ideas on how to promote our influence.
We'll talk about that later. I've got a meeting to rush to. And Louis wants to see the stats on our influencers from day one.
He wants to see the stats? It's all over the place though.
I know, I've been too busy to do any housekeeping. So go through all the files. That's why you got acquainted with Denometrics. Time to put your newfound knowledge to good use. Oh, make it look good for the boss, okay?
Thanks, Sherman.
Thanks for the other night.
I'm glad I could be there for you.
I've been doing a lot of thinking about us. It wasn't fair of me to expect so much from you. Most people would have a hard time accepting the idea, and you were still in love with Shen. I just want you to know you don't have to feel guilty about anything.
But I was wrong for not being upfront with you.
Consider the slate wiped clean. Let's start over. You don't want to?
I'm seeing Avery, and he's been really good to me. I don't want to hurt him. I don't want you to get hurt either. I think we should both take time to think this through. Take things slow, eyes wide open. Make sure no one gets hurt.
I agree, completely. Do you mind just hanging out for a while?
I don't mind at all.
Oh no. Is this what I think it is?
Stenometrics. Sherman just dumped this on my lap.
I was going to ask you to go for lunch, but I think I better buy something back for you then.
Oh yes, please, that would be great. I'm starving. You know, I skipped breakfast this morning so I could come in early to set up for the team meeting.
You know what? I'm going to get takeaways for both of us. I'll give you a hand with this.
Oh, no, it's okay. I can manage.
No, no, I want to help. Sherman's an idiot. He's always pushing us girls around.
Oh, has he been
making me do his work for him? You bet.
Excuse me, Mrs. Shelley. This just came in for you.
Finally.
Is this for the upcoming merger? I can file it with the rest of the documents.
No, 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 no. Far from it. It's the total opposite of a merger. Thank you, Melody.
No problem.
Hi, Shen. How are you doing?
Good.
Really? That's a nice change.
Yeah, I don't know what Ella said to the other guy, but I hope she doesn't stop.
Oh, you have no recollection of it at all?
None whatsoever.
Well, see you.
Oh, wait a second. What was that?
Oh, just thinking. I'll be curious if I were you. Unless you're just saying you feel good.
No, I feel good.
Okay. That guy's kind of snobby.
He's weird. Nice one day, ice cold the next.
I was so hoping this place would be fun. I get to work in social media, make some new friends. And then Sherman happened.
You too? First time I saw Sherman, I thought we could hit it off. He seemed like a really nice guy.
Don't bother. He's the type who just keeps strictly to himself. Now, even at GFBH, he's got this reputation for being a loner.
You seem to know a lot about him.
Yeah? Zarif works at GFBH. He's a doctor. My brother.
Oh. Zarif. Mm-hmm. Why does that sound... Is Zarin your brother? He used to work here, right?
Oh. You've heard of him?
Wait a minute.
You're that intern? Is it true what Louis did to you? Oh my God, do they still talk about that?
Zara, did Louis really hit on you when you were an intern here?
Okay, listen, Melody. I was really impulsive back then, and I did some silly things. But Louis has apologized, and we're good now.
I mean, I heard he was a real playboy in those days, throwing his money at any girl that came his way and treating them like trash.
Yeah, I kind of got him into trouble for that.
You did? This is cool. I know a KSUH legend.
Okay, Melody, let's get back to work, okay? Who's there?
Oh, Rickson. Work problem.
Do you need to go?
Not yet. He can handle it himself.
How's it going, Zara? Still working on the data?
I'm almost done. Can I send it to you in 20 minutes?
You're almost done?
Mm-hmm.
Very impressive. Did someone else give you a hand with this?
Oh, of course I gave Zara a hand. I would much rather start on all this at 5 p.m. and work through the night.
Keep up the good work, Zara.
Such an idiot. Thanks, everyone.
Hi, how's it going?
Good. Much better than the first day.
So you're all up to speed on how things work around here?
Yep, and I'm super busy.
Good.
Oh, Louis. I heard a new batch of interns is coming in. You want some face time with them?
Sure, line them up.
What do you want?
I don't know how Emily puts up with your uncouthness.
Stop wasting my time. What do you want?
Actually, this is about what you want.
Some more games.
I was wrong about you. You're quite a competitive chap. You certainly know how to put up a fight.
What's that? A bride? I already told you how I feel about Emily and Maxine. Keep your money.
This has nothing to do with money. Inside this envelope is what you desperately crave. Status.
And one more thing. Mrs. Shelley says she wants an answer on that proposal by tomorrow morning.
Mommy Eunice, couldn't you just email me all this?
I thought you'd appreciate a more personalized form of service.
Thank you. It was charming. Now please go.
You're quite a hot topic in the office. Everyone loves talking about your loud shirt Playboy days.
What has Zara been saying?
And I heard you had a sidekick called Zareen. And this place was your happy hunting ground.
That was a long time ago. I'm not that guy anymore.
Come on, Louis. Take a break. Tell me about your Hellraiser days. Exactly how many women did you hit on? And how many interns ended up in your trophy cabinet?
Firstly, don't believe everything Zara says. And secondly, we're done here.
I'm just looking for verification. Apparently, no one wearing a skirt was safe from Dr. Lowe. Clients, co-workers, the cleaning lady. Okay, I was kidding. But the cleaning lady's daughter, tell me that isn't true.
Get out of here!
James can come by anytime.
Number one, he's gone out for meetings. And two, you want to run and blab to him about this? To what end?
So you expect me to give up Maxine for this?
To give up your parental rights to Maxine. Take a look inside. I am not lying when I said it would be worth your while. I know you've been there before. You see James pick up a phone, and the problem goes away. Things get done so easily, so quickly. People are only too happy to please someone in his position. That's James. Imagine what it's like for Charles and Derek. You have no idea how much power they have. Take my offer, and you could be moving in the same circles. That's how the rich get richer. You will be rich and powerful and have access. You will be respected. Status.
That's a nice fairy tale.
I know it's difficult for someone like you to comprehend.
I'm a businessman. Everything has a price.
That's the trouble with you. The kind of wealth I'm talking about, the magnitude. Numbers become secondary. You want to spoil Emily just for the heck of it. take her on a weekend shopping spree to Paris and fly first class. Perhaps you wrecked your brand new Lamborghini because you had a few drinks. Simply go out and buy a new one. Take the deal.
Switch tender? Okay, never mind. You think I don't know it's a big project? Ah? Don't be so kanchiong, relax, have a beer.
Oh, what's wrong?
Recent lost a job.
So how? Ma also has to pay to fix the gate.
No problem. Things will change.
Hmm? Oh my god, I would never say those things about you.
Well, that's the impression I got from Melody.
But I don't know who told her all those things, but it didn't come from me.
I'm not sure who to believe right now.
Louis. Okay, I admit I told her that you hit on me when I was interning here, but that was it. All that part about the cleaning lady, okay, that wasn't me, I swear. Are you gonna fire me?
Stop wasting your time on gossip, okay? Just focus on your job.
I am, I've been working really hard. Okay, Louis, I spoke to Melody as a friend, okay? I didn't think...
Sarah, okay, Melody is a troublemaker. All right? She likes to stir the pot. She'll get into your head and she'll mess with it, and I know you're not that kind of person.
No, of course not. I'm not here to play politics.
Fine. Get right to work.
Louis, did Melody really tell you that I said those things about you?
Not exactly. But who else could it have come from? You better watch what you say.
No, are you upstairs already? Okay, I'll see you later.
Avery, is it?
Yeah, he's upstairs at Lux doing measurements for the display booth.
I heard he fought with Adam.
Yeah, Adam said some things about Avery that were totally untrue, so Avery got mad and... Anyway, you know how guys are. They have to act macho and be tough. Anyway, they had a talk and they're okay now.
No wonder you're smiling away.
Guess so.
Guess so, that's all.
I'm okay, okay?
Okay.
Taking a break?
Huh?
How are things with you, Anella?
Couldn't be better.
You know, Dr. Adam is quite the ladies' man. Best not to let him out of your sight.
Adam. I know where he stands with Ella. He's not Shen. Excuse me.
Wait. You're worried about Shen? Why?
It's nothing. I better just wrap things up here.
Look who's here. Hey, lover boy, what's up? You've got a big party or two planned for tonight?
Melody, you can't talk to him like that. He's your boss.
What did you say?
It's true, you're still at work.
Mrs. Shelley is my boss, not Louis.
No, I'm not your boss. But Zara is right. You have to treat your colleagues with courtesy and respect, no matter what the rank is.
You're kidding, right?
No, I'm dead serious.
Melody!
Don't worry about her, Zara. I meant what I said. You were right.
I don't see the envelope on you.
It's somewhere safe.
Do we have a deal?
It's not enough.
Not enough? That's as close to a blank check as you're gonna get. This is a waste of my time.
Okay. You have a deal.
I want it in writing that you're gonna give up your parental right over Maxine.
You have my word.
Not good enough.
How do I know you'll keep your promises?
It will come in time.
And for now, you have my word.
Fine.
Hello, Emily. Hey, don't worry. It went according to plan. You're safe.
Where did you go? Why didn't you pick up your phone?
Eunice wanted to see me. She offered me a deal, but I have to give up my rights to Maxine.
I hope you told her no.
I didn't.
What?
Emily, I will never give up Maxine.
Then call that woman now and tell her no.
It won't stop her. I didn't realize she's so desperate to keep Maxine. I turn her down today, tomorrow she'll come back with something else.
So keep telling her no.
Hey, we keep saying no until she gets fed up and then who knows what she'll do to us.
I don't like this. Why can't she just leave us alone?
Emily. Emily, she wants an answer from me.
Don't give in to her.
I have to take the deal.
No.
Time is on our side. Even if I say, okay, I take the deal, I give up Maxine, she has to call the lawyer. The case has to go to court.
No, Hawk, she's very powerful. She'll find a way to expedite it. Please don't take that risk.
I take the deal. And we get more time to plan our next move.
Which is what? We've run out of moves.
That's why we're stuck. There's no other way. I have to take the deal.
Now she really thinks that you're gonna ditch Maxine and me. I don't like this.
Emily, this will work. Do you trust me? Do you?
Yeah.
I'll never leave you and Maxine. I love you.
I love you too.
Somewhere in and around this neighborhood. You want to be near the restaurant, right?
Don't buy anything on Pearson Road. I don't want to live near that irritating Florence Ching. She will come over every day and criticize our house.
Yes, Chi.
I don't like Jalan Burong. All the houses there get afternoon sun.
Any other requests?
Why can't I have a say?
You can, Chi. It's my money, so I guess I have final say.
I go to work.
What? It is my money.